Welcome, dear students, in this first English digital class. Before we get started, I'd like to say that I will speak English as often as I can. Now, if there are any subjects that I might think that might be difficult to understand, I will swap to Dutch and explain it further. If things are still unclear, you always have the live sessions to ask questions. Even naar het Nederlands dan. Welkom beste leerlingen bij deze eerste digitale Engelse les. Ik zal zo vaak mogelijk als ik kan Engels praten, maar van zodra zaken onduidelijk kunnen zijn, zal ik overschakelen naar het Nederlands, zoals hier. Als het dan nog niet duidelijk is, hebben jullie steeds een vertaling in jullie cursus en kunnen jullie terugvallen op de live sessions. Before we get started, you can see in the PowerPoint, you can see the title here, which refers to the part in the course book that we're talking about. And you can see the pages here. The best idea is to take those pages with you and to take a look at them. We will be talking about the present perfect simple, which we already did before the Easter holidays. Now, both Miss Chauveau and I had the feeling that a bit of more explanation was needed to get it really true. That's what we're going to do this week. Revision. So far, we've rehearsed three tenses. We've rehearsed the present simple, the past simple, and the future simple. So it should ring a bell if I am talking about these tenses. If you forgot about them, you can take a look here. This PowerPoint is on Smart School as well. Or you can take a look in your companion in the compendium in the back of your course book. Dus deze tijden hebben we al herhaald. The present simple, the past simple, and the future simple. Als je dat vergeten bent, kan je hier even gaan kijken of ga je terug in je cursus zoeken naar die tijden. But that was not all. We also talked about the present continuous, the past continuous and the future continuous, which you can see here. Again, if you've forgotten about it, take a look in your course book, take a look at these images or use the internet. But you should know them by now. Dit zijn de andere drie tijden die we al herhaald hebben. Present continuous, past continuous and the future continuous. You should be able to make any exercise filling in all six of those tenses. Now there is a little note. To make it clear what every tense does, it's easy to try and remember to really study by heart these kind of schedules. The simple tenses always are the shortest form of a tense. I eat cake. I ate cake. I will eat cake. Which means that you've got no, or basically only one, auxiliary verb. So it's always very short and it uses no ing form. If you look here, it's always very short. Now, if you take a look at the continuous tenses, they are always longer in duration, meaning that this period of time that you're talking about always lasts longer than just a small moment in time. And they always use the ing form, as you can see here, eating cake. I was eating cake, or I will be eating cake, as you can see here. And they will always use an auxiliary verb, as you can see here. There's always an other verb used. Even in het Nederlands dan. Het is zeer handig voor die tijden om dit soort schema's van buiten te leren. Die maken zaken simpeler. Wanneer je dus begint te twijfelen, present simple, hoe moet ik dat nu weer al maken? Dan moet dat woordje simple jullie al op weg helpen om te weten dat je dan de kortste vorm van het werkwoord gaat gebruiken. De kortst mogelijke vervoeging. Dat was in dit geval gewoon study. Je gaat zelden hulpwerkwoorden tegenkomen, alleen in de future simple. De continuous tense dan. Het woordje continuous duidt al op een continuïteit, iets dat langer duurt. En dan moet je al meteen, moet er een belletje gaan rinken, dat je die ingvorm nodig hebt. Altijd. Wanneer er dus continuous voorkomt in een tense, weet je dat dat eraan vasthangt. En een hulpwerkwoord. Will, to be again. Dus op die manier kan je veel makkelijker je weg vinden in al die Engelse tijden. Now let's take a look at the present perfect simple. If you take a look at all the words, we come at this thing. The present has influence in the present. So it's something that happens actually in the past, but it still has some influence now. The word perfect refers to the past participle, which we translate as voltooid deelwoord. And simple, as always, means no ing form. So you can take a look here. We've got the infinitive, we've got the past simple, and we've got the past participle. This kind of schedule should ring a bell, as you had to learn this already for the irregular verbs. Zoals jullie hier zien, heb ik de tijd even in stukjes getrokken. Je ziet present, dus nu. De tijd heeft dus nog een invloed op de tijd nu, de tegenwoordige tijd. Perfect verwijst altijd naar het gebruik van het volgende deelwoord. En simple, zoals daarvoor gezegd, er wordt dus geen ing-vorm gebruikt. Now, why do we need it? As is written here, for an action that started in the past and is still happening now, or that has a connection to the present. So whatever you started in the past, you're still doing right now, or you still have right now, or you still know right now. It's something that still lives on at the moment. Let's take a look. I've got two examples here. I've lost my keys. I can't get into my house. So I've lost my keys, meaning I still don't have them. I can't get into my house. Or I've known Julie for 10 years. And as you use this tense, you make it very clear that you still know her. So take a look here. This is the moment you met Julie and you still know her right now. Or this is the moment where you lost your keys and you still don't have them right now, meaning you got yourself locked out of your house. Dus waarvoor gebruiken we de present perfect simple? Voor een actie die begon in het verleden en nu nog steeds invloed heeft. Twee voorbeelden daar. Ik ben mijn sleutels verloren en ik ben die nog steeds kwijt. Dat wil zeggen, ik kan mijn huis niet in. Of, ik ken Julie al 10 jaar en ik ken haar nog steeds vandaag. Dus die tijden verwijzen naar het feit dat zaken hier begonnen met het kruisje en dat die vandaag nog steeds invloed hebben. Mocht het zo zijn dat jullie Julie vandaag de dag al 10 jaar niet meer gesproken hebben, dan zou er een andere tijd gebruikt worden. Dat zien we zo meteen. Let's take a look at the grammar rule. You always have your subject, het onderwerp. Then you have to have, het werkwoord dat je dus gaat vervoegen. Followed by the past participle, het voltooid deelwoord. Now the past participle, I can hear you thinking, what is that? For the regular verbs, you always use the infinitive minus 2 plus ed, which takes a look at the past simple. Walked, talked, started, played, all those kind of verbs. Now, as in Dutch, there are some irregular verbs and you need to study them by heart. There is no other way around it. Dus dat voltooid deelwoord, oftewel gebruik je gewoon de past simple vorm, waarbij je dus de infinitief, je laat die toe weg en je voegt ed toe. Dan krijg je walked, talked, started, played and so on. Oftewel ga je voor de onregelmatige werkwoorden en die moet je allemaal van buiten leren. You find all of them, well, not all of them, but those you need to study, you find them in the back of your course book. So the whole thing should be learned by the ending of the year. So you can see it's a little bit of a list. You can make it into a song. To be, was, been, to become, became, become. That's the kind of way you need to study these. Now, as is clearly stated there, these are some irregular verbs, not all of them, but most common ones are listed in your course book. Dus dit is de tabel die jullie van achter in jullie cursus vinden. Die moet tegen het einde van het jaar volledig gekend zijn. Maak er best een soort spelletje van. To hide, hit, hidden. To hit, hit, hit. En zo kan je dat makkelijk van buiten leren. Vergeet wel niet dat dit ze niet allemaal zijn. Er staat duidelijk een aantal onregelmatige werkwoorden. Maar de meest gebruikte staan hier opgelijst. Now the present perfect simple versus the past simple. I can hear you thinking, we're talking about something that happened in the past. So why not just use the past simple? Well, we use the past simple for an action that is completely in the past. It's over now. Let's take a look back at those keys. I lost my keys, but luckily my mum found them in the fridge, meaning I've got them again. There is no influence in the present anymore. I lost them, I got them again. Or the same thing with Julie. I knew Julie for 10 years. But she moved away and we didn't keep in touch. So I don't know her anymore. So it has no use anymore to talk about the present. You can see it quite well presented here. The present perfect, you can see something happened in the past and it still has some influence today. Or something happened in the past and it stayed in the past. It's over now. It has no influence. Dus even de vergelijking tussen the present perfect simple and the past simple. The present perfect simple heeft nog steeds invloed nu. De past simple is iets dat over is, gedaan is. voor bij de sleutels. Ik verloor mijn sleutels, maar mijn mama heeft ze in de kast gevonden. Dat wil dan ook zeggen dat ik ze niet meer kwijt ben. Ik heb ze terug, dus het heeft geen invloed meer op de tijd nu. En bij Julie? Ik kende Julie voor 10 jaar. Ik kende haar 10 jaar lang, maar ze is nu verhuisd en we hebben geen contact meer. Dus het kennen van Julie of de keys zijn allemaal zaken die zich volledig in het verleden bevinden. Je ziet hier een zeer duidelijke afbeelding daarvan. Dus het heeft nog invloed of het is helemaal voorbij. There are some indication words. If you find it difficult to understand, if anything still lasts now, these indication words can help you. You can study them by heart if you find it difficult to decide which tense is a correct one. Deze woordjes, als deze in een zin voorkomen, verwijzen die bijna altijd naar één van de twee tijden. Je kan dit dus van buiten studeren als je het moeilijk vindt om exact te weten welke tijd je moet gebruiken. Here's a little exercise that we will make together right now. I hope that you think along. I will give you the answers immediately, but we try to do it together. Last week, my husband to the supermarket. Something needs to be filled in here now, and it is obviously in the past because there is clearly written last week. Now you need to ask yourself, is my husband still in the supermarket? He went there last week. If it does need to have some influence in the present, you need to think, is he still in the supermarket? Well, probably he isn't. Then you would write down, last week my husband went to the supermarket. You could also know them because of the indication words. As you see, last always refers to the past simple. Deze oefening maken we dus samen. En je ziet daar de eerste zin. Vorige week, puntje, 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 mijn man naar de supermarkt. Dan moet je je afvragen, is mijn man daar nog? Wanneer mijn man daar nu nog zou zijn, dan heeft dat dus wel degelijk invloed op de tegenwoordige tijd. Dan moet ik de present perfect simple gebruiken. De kans is echter groot dat hij daar niet meer is. En dan vul je de past simple in. In dit geval dus, last week my husband went to the supermarket. En het woordje last, dat zagen jullie op de vorige slide, verwijst ook naar die past simple. Since I, my leg, I enjoy reading again. Now you need to ask yourself again, is my leg still broken? It obviously is, because I am still reading. So, since I have broken my leg, I enjoy reading again. Because my leg is still broken. I, Sadie, yesterday. Am I still seeing Sadie right now? Probably not, because I clearly state yesterday. I go to the past simple. I saw Sadie yesterday, because I'm not seeing her anymore at this moment. My toddler, all the cookies at once. Then you need to ask yourself again, is he still eating them right now, or does it have any influence at present? The sentence doesn't really state so, so my toddler ate all the cookies at once. My toddler, all the cookies, and now he's vomiting. Now you need to ask yourself again, does the fact that my toddler ate all the cookies, does that still have some influence right now? Well, clearly yes, because he is vomiting. So, my toddler has eaten all the cookies, and now he's vomiting. There is still some influence in the present. I in this house for my whole life, and I still love it. Am I then still living in this house? Probably yes, because I state that I still love living in it. So I have lived in this house for my whole life and I still love it. I, for years, that's a little mistake there, that something like this would happen. Do I still know it right now? Well, probably yes. So I've known for years that something like this would happen. And in 1666, London to the ground. Is London still burning? Well, no, it happened in 1666. So London, in 1666, London burned to the ground. It's a past simple, it's over now. This was the first part of the video. The second part you'll see later. Dit was het eerste deel. Het volgende filmpje pikt hier meteen op in.